girl Kenzie, and I'm back at it with another video today. So what I'm going to be talking about today is a word called fear. Fear. What is fear? Fear is false evidence appearing real. Okay? And the reason that they call it false evidence appearing real is because it's not based in reality. Most of our fears many times are not based in reality. They're rooted in things that we think that are going to happen that really aren't happening or that really are not going to happen. For example, you might have a fear of public speaking or a fear of expressing yourself. You might think that nobody cares about what you have to say. You might be fearful of how people will receive you, but little do you know that the more you don't express yourself, the more you hold it in, the more you are feeding into that fear. The only way to overcome that fear is to express yourself in order to set yourself free from that fear. So we have to remember that the only way to overcome our fears is to just do it. And I know that can be easier said than done, but we are at a time in the energy where we really need to push ourselves, guys. We have to push past fears because a lot of people right now are going through seasons of doubt. They're going through seasons of uncertainty where they don't necessarily know how they're going to get out of the situations they're in. And the way to get out of the situation is to overcome fear. We have to overcome the fear in our hearts. Some people have a fear of life. They're scared of what's going to happen when they wake up in the morning. We have to go inward and find peace, because when you have inward peace, that fear doesn't bother you. That fear doesn't shake you, man. They can try you, but they can't have you because you got peace within. You have peace in your soul. Okay? God wants me to tell a lot of you that you need to surrender to Him. I feel like some of you are seeking validation outside of yourself. You're seeking validation from loved ones, from friends, from family members. You need to seek validation from spirit. You need to seek validation from God. Seek validation from Jehovah. Seek validation from your higher power. He's the one that validates you. He is the one that's going to help you to free yourself from these fears, from these chains, because fear can chain us. It can gripple us and cripple us and keep us bound. We have to unbound ourselves so we can reach our full potential, okay? And it's okay to be lonely right now. That's another thing God wants me to tell you guys. Some of you are going through seasons of loneliness for a reason. God is making you lonely. He's making you isolated so that He can work on you, so that He can speak to you. He can't speak to you if you're around a bunch of people that are going to stop His voice from being heard by you. God is working in your life and you have to let Him. Sometimes when God is working in our life, we think that it's going to be all beautiful and sunshine, but it's not. Sometimes that causes us to have fear, causes us to have doubt, causes us to feel lonely, isolated. But we have to keep the faith because there's a greater power at work that wants the best for us. Spirit is guiding us to our greatest potential. But in order to be guided to our greatest potential, we have to overcome fear. And I know that even me myself was going through this. Some days I would just wake up and have such a fear of life. We got to get out of that. I had to realize that I had to start meditating. This is something that we have to start doing. Going inward, meditating, searching for peace within ourselves, making our immediate environments clean and beautiful and appealing to the eye. These are some things that we can do to overcome fear and to generate peace within. All right, so I just want to kind of do a wrap up. So fear is false evidence appearing real. In order to overcome fear, we have to overcome the seasons of doubt that the universe presents us with. Sometimes we have to surrender to spirit. We have to surrender to God and know that in order to reach our full potential, our highest calling, we're going to have to be lonely and isolated. I love you guys. Peace, love, and light. Let me know in the comments what you think about what I had to say. Let me know in the comments if some of you are going through this. If some of you are feeling isolated and lonely. How do you deal with it? Remember to stay positive, stay grounded, and just remember that you are a queen, you're a superwoman, and you were born to make manifest the glory of God that is within you. It's not just in some of us, it's in all of us. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. Peace.